tag, you're it. Actually, not a bad analogy for the slash tag command. Slash tag is simple, but very powerful. A tag is literally just a piece of text, and every entity in the world has a list of tags associated with it. Each entity is born into the world with no tags on it, but they can be added and removed with slash tag. Let's place down an armor stand, convenient because it won't run away. While looking directly at it, type slash tag, and after a space, you will see a list of all the at selectors, all the online players, and the ID of the entity you are looking at. Select that ID, and type another space. Now we can pick add to add a tag, then type whatever we want to be a tag. I'll add a tag called test. Now we can select this entity by doing at e tag equals test. To prove that it worked, I'll test it with slash say at e brackets tag equals test. Just like that. It'll make me say a list of all entities tagged with test. Armor stand, very nice. To get rid of the tag, we can run a tag command just like before, but instead of adding the tag, we choose remove. Okay, cool. I'm sure you could have figured all that out by yourself, but what is slash tag commonly used for? Well, I'm glad you asked. Tags are great for keeping track of entities permanently or temporarily. By the way, I'm gonna be using Visual Studio Code to make a data pack for this tutorial because I think it's a little easier to write, a little easier to understand, but if you've never used it before, you should check out my data pack tutorial. I'll run you through how to set it up real quick in that video. All right, you good to go? Great. Let's say we want to make a function that gives everyone except you a cooked pork chop. First, we can do tag at s add self. This will add a tag to the person who runs this function, so at s. Then we can do give at a tag equals exclamation point self cooked pork chop. The exclamation point means not, so everyone without the self tag will be given a cooked pork chop. Then we just remove the tag with tag at s remove self. Great, now let's test it in game. Oh wait, it's just me in here. Okay, for a permanent tracking example, let's say we want to make all zombies spawn with an iron sword. We can do replace item entity at e type equals zombie tag equals exclamation point sword, so tagged without the sword tag. Replace their weapon.mainhand with an iron sword. Then we can do tag at e type equals zombie tag equals not sword. So every zombie that hasn't been given a sword will add the sword tag so that they aren't constantly getting new swords and to reduce lag. You can summon an entity with tags pre-applied as well. This is super useful for when you want to do something with an entity as soon as it spawns. To do this, summon your entity as normal, and then at the end, in the NBT tags, add a tag called tags, and fill it out like this. Open close brackets, close everything off, and then in here, put tag 1, comma, tag 2, comma, tag 3. Tag 1, tag 2, and tag 3 are just examples here, obviously. You can have as many or as few as you want. Now we've summoned an armor stand with 3 tags. Excellent. To add on to this, you can make spawn eggs that spawn pre-tagged mobs. The command for that looks like this. I'll put this and any other commands in the description for you to copy and paste. In summation, tags are incredibly useful, and are the main way of keeping track of entities with commands. Because of that, there's no main use case for them. They're just used for everything. Getting comfortable manipulating tags to do your bidding is a crucial step to becoming a necromancer, I mean data pack creator. Tags tie in extremely well with the slash execute command, so if you don't know how to use it yet, you should go check out my tutorial on it. This is also a great time to learn about data packs. Go watch my tutorial on them here. My name is Legitimoose, and thank you for watching.